Team Vanglory. We're doing a Nova Grappler Viktor deck profile. So we're going to start with the starter. This is Extreme Battle with Kabutron. I prefer this one because it's just max aggression with me. Like, I don't want to sit there passively and do things. A lot of people like to play Rumble because it stands up whatever unit also stands in front of it. But this gets you another attack off and wastes one of your resources, so that gets your G-Guardian alive for more guard. Plus, this will stand up, this can stand up your Sazander or your Sever Temper, and that'll get you attack going for 16 as opposed to like 14.
Combo super well.
I guess we're gonna do triggers first, because that's what I have this stacked up as. The way I play it, you need to draw your pieces, unfortunately, in this deck, because searching is too strong for Bushiroad and Nova Gobblers, apparently. So I play 4 break pass, the Viktor crit, 5k to the Vanguard for the end of turn, when it attacks. That's just standard. I play 2 red lightning, because whenever you need that extra counter blast to win, it's there sometimes, hitting guard with it. Play 6 draw triggers overall, and guess what? None of my draw triggers do anything, because Bushiroad hates Nova Grapplers. But like I said, you need to draw into your pieces, otherwise you're just going to lose. Otherwise, you're stuck with like bad pieces, nothing that does anything. And then lastly, obviously, you're going to go with the 4 heal trigger, because you want to heal, you want to G-guard, whatever. That's how it goes, right? I'm going to go into grade 1s next. Obviously, you're going to start with 4 perfect guards. There's really no other perfect guards you run in this deck than Lady Cyclone, the unflipping one. Because if you ride it and you end up soul blasting it from an effect, you have it in the drop zone already for your unflips. The other perfect guard is really not that great. It's a counter blast, and you have to get an intercept. But half the time, you're not gonna have anything on the board anyway because hand trap.
Counter blast doesn't come easy.
It really doesn't. I play 2 Furious Puncher because when you don't have Maliaki, it comes in super clutch and wins games. Also, it's a target. If it's in the front row in front of your starter, people like to attack it, and that's something they're not hitting my Vanguard with. Then I play 4 Maliaki because this card is absolutely phenomenal. It's actually the linchpin of this deck. Whenever the unit in front of it stands up and attacks, it gains a skill that when that unit attacks, it gives 2 units 4k, which means it can give itself and another unit 4k. However, what a lot of people don't know is this unit that stands and attacks, if it attacks again in the same turn, it gains the skill once again, meaning it stacks. So the first time it'll be 4-4, the second time it'll be 8-8, 12-12, so on and so forth. So if you keep standing, you're getting power to 2 units over and over, and it's insane.
I actually didn't know that. Well, that's pretty cool.
And then I play 4 Strike Fodder, because, Strike Fodders. You want to strike, you do things. Going on to grade 2s next. Let's see. New card promo that came out recently. 4 Sever Temper. This card is actually amazing. For one, it's a Viktor Restricted Sazanda. But it's better than Sazanda because it looks cooler. This one's full art. But also it has a secondary skill. When you drive check a 3 on your turn, obviously your turn, you retire a unit in your opponent's front row. So if you drive check 2 grade 3s, or you have 2 of them on the board and you check a 3, you retire 2 units on the front row, and your opponent can't really say anything about it unless they have resist or whatnot. So it comes in pretty clutch when you're checking 3s and you don't want them, but if they don't have a board, they have to drop more cards or some call more cards from wherever. 4 Arboreal, which is the Glimmer clone for this deck. This card is really good, in my opinion. Some people don't want to play it at 4, but I think the card, you have to play it at 4 because you want to see it all the time. Counterblast, Soul Blast, choose a unit on the board already. That unit's going to stand when this unit attacks and this unit becomes 11k. That's a number, so it's not 9, they have to deal with it, or they have to take the hit. But whatever happens, even if it attacks and they can't hit, the unit will still stand. So when this unit stands due to Abreu's skill, it's going to stand, and this unit will become plus 10 because of his own skill, which is really good. It's also a target for someone to hit later. It doesn't do anything after you use a skill, like any Glimmer Clone, so you can intercept with it, or you just, people will attack it because they don't know with any of the cards, you know?
Yeah, it's phenomenal,
actually. Moving on, I play two Cool Hank because it can get really cloggy at more than two, in my opinion. A lot of people like to play it at four, along with four Arboreal, but like at that point, if you have that many in hand, you're probably not getting the other pieces that you need. It's the Amber Clone for this deck. You, when it's boosted, you choose a unit, stand it, and give it 5k. So like I said, again, works with Severed Temper. The Severed Temper, if it hasn't already stood, it'll become 19 on some. Really good. Still a good card from set G1. It's worth playing. And then my personal tech, I still play two old school Street Bouncer. I mean, the new one is okay. Ernest, I think his name is. You have to Soul Blast for it, but I mean that card, it'll fuel your new G Guardian that Soul Charges and then flips. But like sometimes you don't want the Soul Blast because maybe they killed your starter, so you don't have the extra Soul Blast, and you need the Soul Blast for Arboreal. That's not Arboreal. That is. It works early game. It just rests the column, and then later that turn it becomes an intercept on their turn. That's about it. I think it's okay. Moving on to grade threes. A lot of people don't agree with me on this. I've talked to other people on the Facebook groups for no grapplers, but I prefer to play the new Viktor at four because its GB2 isn't really that good, but it goes live automatically when you stride, because normally all your strides get you to GB2 automatically on your first stride. But it's mainly because you can stand up a whole column instead of just one unit, as opposed to the old Viktor. So say you have this column on any side, and you have a Maliaki. Maliaki gives a unit in front of a rush, so say this wasn't already a rush unit, you could choose the unit in front of Maliaki, and they would both stand up due to Extreme Viktor's skill. And it's a Soul Blast as opposed to a Counter Blast, meaning you have more Counter Blast to do things with Cool Hank and Arboreal. But it's really good. I think it also, I mean, the GB2 is not amazing, but it makes things relevant. Say you had this card and Cool Hank in the same column and you swung and then you stood up a rear guard version of this, it would stand and then it would make this column 16 because he gives 2k to the front row when this unit stands. So that's a 10k shield as opposed to a 5k shield.
It's all about synergy.
I mean, it does things. Yeah, whatever. And then I play the original Viktor at three. Still a really good card. Sometimes it's better to go into and as opposed to the new Viktor, just because you want to use that extra counter blast because you have the heal trigger in hand and you don't want to waste it and not get the shield you need. But still does things. But the GB2 is still extremely strong, so you can't stride, but you only has like four cards in because they didn't win on their turn. You can still go off and win as opposed to with this card.
Yeah.
Moving on to the G Zone. For Mediokaiser Viktor, this card is amazing in my opinion. Like, this card alone can push your opponent to 5 damage on the first stride if you're doing things in of your pieces. It's an axe skill, flip a copy, there's no cost. You flip a copy and when this unit will hit, it's an on hit, so it's the same thing as the Vic 10, which is it doesn't flip anything. But were this to hit, you choose another unit after it attacks and hits, and you stand that unit to give it 5k. And then GB3, which is when it really becomes clutch, say you G-guarded first, and your opponent stride on your turn, this unit will stand a unit, give it 5k, without having to hit, and then if you do hit, you stand another unit to give it 5k. So when it synergizes with both of the grade 3s, because... So when you stride bonus, Soul Blast 1, you'll stand the column if it's rush, and then he'll stand the other unit. So you'll have two standing columns after you swung like three or four times with your rear guard. So then you have more attacks and more places to apply triggers to, which is really good. Pretty good card. Actually, it's a phenomenal card. I don't. You wouldn't play it at less than four. Next, we play four Viktor Plasma. A lot of people don't agree with me here, but I think this card still is really good because it's going to restand no matter what you do. There's no clauses for it. You just counterblast two, you pitch two after it attacks, you're standing up. You lose a drive check both times, so you only get one drive, but we need it. It's there for our bad matchups, so it's just, you get it. And then, a lot of people don't know, but Maliaki gives power to any unit, not just a rear guard. So you don't boost the first time, and then you boost the second time, and the column is bigger if you don't have rear guards. So if they don't have another perfect guard, they have to guard more from hand, G-guard, whatever.
Helps a bunch against Link Joker.
It really does. Next, I play one of the new finishing stride, Favorite Champ Viktor. Honestly, if you don't win on this stride, you lose because you have nothing in hand. But this card is actually probably the only thing keeping this deck in the game right now. As you know, it's not even, this deck's not top tier, but it's my favorite clan because I start off with it. This card, when it swings, you choose, after you swing, you do drive checks, you choose as many units as you have face up in the G zone, you stand them. And then you counterblast two for that. And then if you stood more, three more units, you discard three. You stand this unit as well, and it loses two drive checks. But that is not a once per turn skill. So having the cards in hand, you can do it again after you attack the second time. You lose all drive checks, but if you're attacking a third time with the Vanguard, they probably can't guard it anyway, and you win. Actually a really awesome card, but there's no reason to play more than one of it. Next, we have Meteor Crusher Tribute, which is Fighter's Collection G1. This card actually gets in there pretty hard. A lot of people don't know it. When your unit stands by effect due to your card on your turn, you counterblast one, choose a unit that has less than the power that the unit that you stood, and you retired. But this is not once per turn either. So if you feel like wasting all your counterblasts and retiring your opponent's board just to make them mad, and you have the G guard, you have, you know, the heel trigger in hand for the G guard, all go for it. It's fun to do. Your opponent gets mad. Why not? Also, I play two Buster, which is from Fighter's Collection from last year. Fighter's Collection 3, I think. It, say you need to stand more than one unit a turn, you don't have pieces on your stride turn. This allows you to get another attack off. Instead of just standing one column, you can stand the other column as well. It's a persona. It's actually not a persona, you can flip anything, but it's preferred to flip itself. I only play two of it, so I'm never going to use it for its second ability to restand. It's just there in case I don't have my pieces, and it's an emergency precaution. That's about it. Still a pretty good card. Moving on to G-Guardians. I play a one-of Tribute because sometimes I don't want to leave my my important units out there. Like, I have... We don't have searching power in this deck, so sometimes I need to protect my units, my Maliakis, my... pretty much anything that's like super important. Maliaki is a pretty big like target that you need to protect. What else? It's a great tease. I think I lost him.
Right,
I know. This guy. This is probably the card you want to protect the most with Gizmo. Gizmo says they can hit it, it can't be retired. So unless the unit gets retired or locked due to a column, mass retire, mass lock, or like a column choose, then it's pretty much safe for the turn and you don't have to lose the unit. I think this is a staple in a lot of decks because you want to protect your units because that unit's probably going to win you the game. And then I play three of the new G-Guardian from set 10. Unior, this card's amazing.
It's
dumb. It's, say you wasted all your resources and your opponent's like, yeah, now you can't do anything. And you're like, nah, just G-Guardian. I get my Soul Blast and my Counter Blast back because why not? And then for both times you get 5k, so you pick up a 25k shield on its own if you wasted all those resources and you didn't win that turn. I think it's an amazing card. It's really strong.
Awesome, Egan. What would you say is your toughest matchup with this deck?
Everything. No,
specifically
any deck that can, well, there's two ways to go about it. Any deck that can rush harder than us, because this deck has no, absolutely, outside of this guy, we have no early game presence at all. So this is really, you draw a card, hey. But I lost an attack, so I'm not putting on pressure, but I'm getting cards for later. And most you can do is probably throw down units that you know your opponent will swing at, and you protect your Vanguard for later, so they don't rush you. Anything with an early game, Night Rose, Roy Paladins, like all Roy Paladin decks can just totally destroy this deck. Hell, prisms. I hit, I draw, and I get to bounce. Oh, look, I have two cards in hand for free. Anything with an early game fucks us, and also late game, or actually mid game, control decks destroy this deck overall. Like, Ling Choker is hella hard. Cogro is annoying because they have Denial Griffin and they have Defeat Flare. Night Rose has Denial Lily plays with the G-Guardian. That's phenomenal. You just gotta get there. You gotta hope they don't do things and you can kill them in one turn. Otherwise, you're gonna die.
Yeah, makes sense. Alright, well, thanks Egan for the Viktor deck profile. And this is Vanglory with your Van Story. We out.
Peace out.